and we are away in the first final of the day. Great Britain in lane two will look for a fast first 500 metres. They'll then settle over the next 500, and it'll be steady acceleration from 1,000 metres out. Italy, nearest the cameras, have already dropped back. Britain, you see over there next to the far lane, have already made a very good start and are leading. At Lucerne, Britain struck a very shrewd psychological blow with a victory in a final that included four of the crews in this race of the United States boat. Not the US 4 that rode twice at Lucerne and lost only to East Germany and Britain. That crew is broken up. Two of them, in fact, are in the Cox Pairs final. But the United States have been fast and impressive, and in fact, at the moment, have probably a quarter of a length lead over Great Britain. Great Britain, with Adrian Ellison, the cox. Stroke is Stephen Redgrave, and in weight, and Bow Martin Cross. But it is still the United States with Italy, who were also fast in their heat, on the near side in second place, and Britain in third. These are the Americans. Ross Tong, rather repechage. The best time was easily that of the British four. More than 3 seconds better than the next fastest, who were the United States, finishing second in the British heat. Between those two crews at the moment. 1250 meters to go. The United States half a length, 3 minutes and 9 seconds was the British time at the 1000 meter mark in their heat. So we're a bit faster than that today, and the United States have certainly laid down a challenge. Britain. Martin Cross, Richard Budgett, Andy Holmes at stroke, Stephen Redgrave. Man who wanted to come here as a single sculler was persuaded to take the stroke seat in the Cox 4. And really a very tight race between these two, and it may well prove to be all on the last 500 meters. This was the event that produced one of the most exciting finishes when the games at Stockholm in 1912. United States now extending their lead. Maybe half a length. Gold and silver. 500 meters to go, half a length for the United States. The British four, representing the cream of British rowing, filtered out from a squad of 50 potential Olympic rowers. And now they're beginning to show their burst. This is where the British will be strong, and this race is not over yet by any means. United States trying to hold, and Britain producing their burst now, and this looks good. Adrian Ellison calling for the big effort now, and here they come. There is nothing in it now, and with every stroke the British are gaining through the mist on the Americans. Looking over their shoulder, you saw a glance there from Richard Budgett, and the British are now beginning to turn the pressure on the Americans, and it'll be interesting to see if the Americans can hold them. Great Britain with a very heavy crew, just about 14 stone 10 per man average, and Britain row through the mist with now only a, and Britain are going to win the gold. Britain first, the United States second. They cross the line now, and there is gold for Great Britain. Martin Cross, Richard Budgett, Andy Holmes, Stephen Redgrave, Adrian Ellison, the cox, and those are names that will go down. They've rowed themselves virtually to the point of exhaustion. This is a sport which makes such physical demands that in the last stages of the race, the demand for oxygen can be so great that it's not the of these knowledgeable spectators. Cross, Budgett, Holmes, Redgrave, and down there, Adrian Ellison, the 23rd Olympia.
Winners of the gold medal and Olympic champions, the team from Great Britain.
Confidence and a faith and now receiving their gold medals.
Adrian Ellison.
A kiss for them all.
Medaille d'argent.
Kiss ever knows in his career. Moment that gets to us all.
Moments for us here at home as well. There's confirmation of the Cox Fours with great